Good afternoon, all. I'm Chandramali. This is our study. We can have a relationship between microalbuminuria and hyperlipidaemia. Subject with hypertension attending family practice center, University of Sri Jayewardenepura. First of all, I would like to give you a brief introduction. As all you know, albumin is the one that protein in blood, but in trace amount in urine. When a ratio of albumin to urine creatinine comes between 30 to 300 milligrams per gram, it is considered as microalbuminuria. So, this microalbuminuria is considered as a pathological condition. When come to the hypertension patients, microalbuminuria in hypertension patients is caused by elevation in intraglomerular pressure due to hemodynamic changes and renal systemic albumin leakage due to endothelial dysfunction. When hemodynamic changes, hemodynamic factors change, it will increase the intraglomerular pressure and glomerular capillary injury will lead to microalbuminuria. Then when come to the endothelial dysfunction, it will increase the permeability of endothelium and it leads to penetrate lipoprotein particles into vessel wall. On one hand, it will end up with microalbuminuria, and the other hand, it will lead to forming of atherosclerotic plaques, which leads to cardiovascular diseases. So why we need to do this kind of study? Because cardiovascular diseases has increased, and this may help to understand association of microalbuminuria and risk factors of cardiovascular diseases. And it may provide evidence for screening patients with abnormal albumin excretion and their risk for cardiovascular diseases. And it will help to use microalbuminuria as an early marker. So our general objective is to determine the relationship between microalbuminuria and hyperlipidemia in subjects with hypertension attended to family practice center. To achieve that objective, we separate it into these specific objectives. Those are to determine albumin and creatinine levels in collected urine samples, to determine the albumin to creatinine ratio, to describe the association of albumin to creatinine ratio levels in social demographic factors, to determine living parameters of collected blood sample, and to describe the relationship of microalbuminuria with each lipid parameter in lipid profile. So our study was cross-sectional study, and this study setting was Family Practice Center, University of Sri Jayewardenepura. And study population was patients who were attending to the Family Practice Center with this inclusion and exclusion criteria. We include 35 to 70 years old diagnosed hypertensive patients who were attending to family practice center, and we exclude diagnosed patient with any cardiovascular disease, any renal disease, and patients with diabetes, and people who were detected to have abnormal urine creatinine level at the baseline screening. So our sample size was calculated using this equation, and we recruited 100 people. However, 4 people were excluded due to high albumin levels at the initial screening. There were administrative questionnaires used as our study instrument to collect the demographic data. This study was conducted after obtaining the ethical approval from the Ethical Review Committee of Faculty of Medical Sciences, University of Sri Jayewardenepura, and patient participants were informed about the study by giving an information sheet. Also, written informed consent was obtained from participants. measurements of height and weight was took by using electronic visual scale and fixed radiometer respectively, and BMI was calculated according to the formula. And in the morning, after 12-hour fasting, blood sample was collected by veteran nurse, and the morning and the urine sample was taken for the microalbumin assay and the creatinine assay. Urine analysis was done by using 20XT automated analyzer in biochemistry department. Urinary albumin was measured by commercial immunoturbidimetric assay, and the urine creatinine level was measured by a kinetic method. Lipid profile parameters was measured by using thermoscientific indigo biochemical analyzer. Data analysis was done by using statistical package of social sciences software version 21 and independent sample data scan. Serum and correlation was used to obtain the final results. This is the distribution of albumin-creatinine ratio levels in our study population. As you can see, this 2% of proteinuria uremic subjects were excluded at the beginning of our study because they were inferior to our final results. In table number 1, here we show distribution of normal and abnormal subjects in relation to lipid parameters in our study population. And in table number 2, here we show mean comparison of age, BMI and lipid parameters of subjects in normal albuminuria and microalbuminuria. As you can see here, according to p-values, there is no significant association between these two independent samples. But when come to the microalbumin uremic sample, in table number 3 you can see correlation of microalbuminuria with age, BMI, lipid parameters. There is a positive monolith correlation with total cholesterol and LDL. And so we conclude microalbuminuria is correlated with total cholesterol and LDL level and no correlation with HDL and triglyceride, H and BMI. So there are some past studies which got the similar results similar to in our study, there are some limitations also. We could not determine the effect of antihypertensive drugs and dose of the drugs on microalbuminuria, and unable to assess some patients' past clinical history. The recommendations are further studies on association between effect of antihypertensive drugs and drug dose of antihypertensive and microalbuminuria is recommended, and subjects for this study could be recruited from island-wide distribution with increasing sample size. These are our references, and I would like to thank Dr. Wijesekara, Dr. Chandramali, Samaranayaka, supervisors for their great support at the beginning, and the Department of Community Medicine, University of Sri Jayewardenepura, all the academic and non-academic staff members of Medical Laboratory Sciences Unit and the Practice Center, Department of Biochemistry, all the participants, and the chairperson of KDO IRC committee. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Any questions from anyone? Very interesting paper, important subject.
When you recruited these hypertensive patients, did you make a special note about that duration of being diagnosed as hypertension?
Yes, ma'am. We didn't recruit patients who are suffering more than 5 years. We didn't we didn't recruit because it is difficult to access their past history. That's why we recruit only patients who are suffering within 5 years. Recently, who
she used between recently diagnosed 5 years.
Recently diagnosed.
So did you like have their previously done lipid profile readings, etc., to compare at least?
No, ma'am.
Thanks.
Interesting, because I put microalbuminuria in their views for people with this category of illness. A great number of people will die, mortality higher, particularly from cardiovascular disease. So you have shown the hypertension is one aspect of cardiovascular disease. And hypercholesterolemia also is very closely to cardiovascular disease. There you are talking about a very important segment of the population who is sick. Thank you very much. In the absence of any other questions, then we will go on to the last paper for today.
Thank you.